Tutorial, let's learn about how to design a data structure, which is also known as a multiplexer, using VHDL. So before starting with VHDL, I would recommend you to read this article so that you'll know the basics of multiplexer, what are the configurations of a multiplexer, how it is used in the electronics world. So now I will show you how to implement the multiplexer in VHDL programming. So firstly, the libraries are imported and the entity declaration has been done. So I have used MUX41 as my entity label and I have declared the input and output signals. So usually a data selector will have input line, output line and a selection line and an enable port. Enable port is nothing but an on or off switch in an electronic device. So that is very similar to an electronic device. And secondly, select line. Select line is nothing but the number of inputs that has to be given for selection process. Nextly, the signal, which is called as the data input, is the input data, which is 3 down to 0. So which means if it is a 4 cross 1 multiplexer, then it's 3 down to 0. So I have done the entity declaration. Next is the architecture declaration. So I've used SIM as my label and I've ended with the same label SIM. Next, I'm going to declare the outputs of the signal. So in order to declare the output, what I have done is I've used when and else conditions. So when this condition is there, the output will be mapped to the values of the data 3. And similarly, the other three conditions are mentioned using the when else statements. Always mention the both conditions, that is the select line and the enable line, because if enable line is 0, then the multiplexer will not function. So that's what I mentioned here. In VHDL programming, the letter X, it means it refers to undefined state. So after this condition has been executed, else, so data will become X if enable has been 0. So this is the full programming for the multiplexer 4:1. So let's simulate this. Go to simulate, start simulate. So I have compiled and simulated the same code. I'm gonna force values and add waves. So if you can see the data is four bit. So it's now the array is of 4 size and select line is of 2 bit size. So I given 2 bit size and enable is a single line. So I just given as a standard logic and output a single line. So say I'm gonna give my data line as post the values, I'm giving one as 1000. Select line is, I'm gonna give say 00. And I'm not enabling circuit. Just for your understanding purposes, I want to show you. So I'm gonna give it as 0. Let's see what is the output. Now you can see that when enable is 0, output is X, which means it's undefined. Though the inputs are given, though selection line inputs are given, the output is 0 because the circuit is not enabled. So let's switch on the circuit. Let now change to 0 to 1. Okay. Now we can see that there is some output. So the first output is 1000 and selection port is 00, which means it will select the first bit, which is 1. That's what we can see in the output. Say I'm gonna change it to 1010. Click OK and I'm going to force the values to select the values to 10. Now again you can see that if the selection value is 10, it will select the third input, third value of the input, which is nothing but 1. So from these graphs we can understand that how these things will work. If I again change enable this to 0, switch it off, again it will be undefined state. So this is what multiplexer is all about. So try different values of the input, try different values for selection line, so we'll get an idea. Next, what will you see is the exact opposite of multiplexer, which is called the demultiplexer. So this is nothing but an opposite operation performed by an electronic device. how like you know 4x1 multiplexer, it's the opposite, it's called as 1x4 demultiplexer. The input is always one, so that's why I always given no input is always just a one single port. Selection line remains the same too, and enable a single logic signal, that's one, and output is four. So as earlier said, I've done all the library importation, entity declaration with the same variables, and the architecture has been defined. So now we have so many outputs to be declared. Since we have four outputs declared, I've used the if-else conditions. So if you refer to the previous article on designing of IC-based, Boolean-based IC design, you'll see how if-else conditions have been used. The same method and the same modeling has been used in this designing of demultiplexer. So since the output depends upon the select and enable inputs, I have given the select line and enable values inside the process. So it will process those values, and depending upon these values, it will take the output values. So for example, for the first condition given as, if enable is 1 and select line is 0, perform the following task. So similarly, I given the next other three conditions given below, and we have to also mention what will be the case if enable is 0, right? So what I have done is I have given all the enable 1 conditions firstly, and after that I given if nothing is out of these four conditions, then it is going to be this performing tasks. So this is again nothing but X is nothing but undefined state. So just copy paste this code I have given this the same code in the article, and try to simulate this. I'll simulate this for you now and show how it works. Okay, select DMX41. The waveform window will open now. Yeah, now you can see that there's only one variable for data, and select line is 2 and enable is 1, but output now it's 4 because we said it's just an opposite of multiplexer, so which means 1 is to 4 demux. So I'm gonna say I'm gonna give it as 1. Okay, and select line as 0 0. And enable first line, and I'm switching it off. Now you can see that enable is 0, so a circuit is not able to judge what the output will be, so it's undefined. Say I'm going to switch on the circuit now. Yeah, now you can see that this is the data line. The data line has come to the first bit of the output. Say next you choose select next bit of selection pin 001. You can see that from now that the one is shifted from the 0th place to the first place. So I'm going to change the next values. Yeah, now you can see the difference between how the data is traveling throughout the output values. So when you change the selection value inputs, the data will be traveling from one port to another. So if I change this to 10 to 11, it will move to the last bit of the output. So you know, so this is for 00, this is for 01 and 110 and 111. So this is how you design a multiplexer and a demux using a VHDL. Please refer to the article before coming to this video so that you'll get an insight what mux and demux are exactly are. Thank you.